So, hey guys, so today I want to bring you a very interesting topic, IP address and subnets. So we have got two modules. The first module will talk about IP address, then the next module will talk about subnets. So let's understand first what is an IP address. An IP address identifies a node in a network. Okay, so for example, let's say you want to connect your computer to the internet. You will need to apply for an IP address so that you can be able to access the internet. And take a note here that an IP address is an attribute of a network device interface, not an attribute of a network device itself. What do I mean when I say that? What I mean is this, that let's say, for example, a network device has multiple interfaces. Each interface will be assigned an IP address, okay? To understand an IP address properly, we're gonna discuss about the classes of IP address. So we have got five classes: class A, class B, class C, class D, up to class E, with the ranges given here. So class A range from 0 to 127, class B range from 1 to 8 to 191, class C range from 192 to 223, class D range from 2 to 4 to 239, class E range from 240 to 255. So the first three, that's class A, class B, and class C, can be used for hosts. But for the last two, cannot be used by hosts. So for class D, it is used for multicast. Then class E is used for research work. Okay. So given an IP address, how will you know this is a class A, this is a class B, this is a class C, this is a class B, or this is a class E, when you don't know the range? First of all, what you can do to identify the class in which it belongs, take the first octet, convert it to binary number. If you convert it to binary and the first bit is zero, you know it's a class A. Same thing for class B. Convert the first octet into binary. If the first two bits are 1, 0, you know it's a class B. So on and so forth, up to class E. Then, we also have to understand the structure of an IP address. So an IP address has two parts, the network part and the host part. So how can you know this is a network part and this is a host part? So to be able to identify that, you have what is called network mask. So network mask is used to differentiate the network and host part. So sometimes the network mask can be referred as the default subnet. Let's say for class A. Class A, the first 8 bits are set to 1, which represent the network. Then the last 24 bits are set to zeros, which represent the host part. Same to class B, the first 16 bits are set to 1, which represent the network. Then the last 16 bits are set to zeros, which represent the network. So therefore, the default subnet for class B will be 255.255.0.0. So from that, we'll be able to identify the network part, because already the host part will be zeros. Okay, so let's continue. So we said class D and class E are preserved, so we don't focus on them. So next is IP address. So here, we're gonna talk about the network address and the broadcast address. So what is a network address? A network address is just used to identify host. A network address is just used to identify a network. Let's take an example here. 192.168.10.0/24/24 tells you that it's a class C. Okay, so meaning that the first 24 bits represent the binary one. Okay, so we change it to default subnet mask will be 255.255.255.0. So to identify the network, we'll set the host bit to 0. So therefore, our network address will be 192.168.10.0. You see here, set to 0. Then we have broadcast address. This is a special address used to send data to all hosts in a network. So identifying a broadcast, we set all the host bits to 1. Because it's a class C, the hosts are represented by binary zeros, which are 8 in number. So when we set them all 1, we'll have our broadcast. Therefore, our broadcast will be 192.168.10.255. Then again, we have a very interesting part here called available addresses. There's total address and available address. So how do we get total address? Total address is just given by the 2 power n. N here is the number of host bits, which are given in zeros. Then available addresses will be given by 2 power n minus 2. Why are we subtracting 2? This is the network address and the broadcast address. Here is a note that network and broadcast address cannot be directly used by device. That is, they cannot be directly assigned to host. So to get this point clearly, we have a formula here. Given that host part of a network segment is n bits, so n bits, this one represents the host. So therefore, our formula for the total number of addresses will be given by 2 power n. Then the number of available IP addresses will be 2 power n minus 2, where minus 2 here are the network and the broadcast address. Then we have IP address calculation. This one is where we are able to identify the host part and the network part. So first of all, you are given this IP address. Then they want you to identify the network address in it, broadcast address in it, and number of available addresses. Also, they can ask you to identify the host address from this address. So first of all, what we do is to find its network mask. So this is slash 16, meaning that its default mask will be 255.255.0.0. So from that, we have got the first 16 bits set to 1, then the last bit set to 0. So from this point, we'll be able to identify the network part and the host part. So after identifying the network part and the host part, we set all the host bits to 0. We say here, we see here, they were 10.1. We now set all of this to 0. So therefore, we'll have our network to be 172.16.0.0/16. And what about broadcast? So to be able to get broadcast, we set all the host bits to 1. So meaning that when we set all the host bits to 1, our broadcast address therefore will be 172.16.255.255, because the host bits are set to 1. So here is what we are given. So to get the total number of addresses, we use the formula 2 power n. N here is the number of host bits. Host bits are now 16, right? Which give us a total of this one. Then the number of available addresses. These are the addresses that can be assigned to host. Will be 2 power 16 minus 2, which give us that one. So the total range of addresses that can be assigned to host will start from dot 1 all the way to 254. Okay. So here is another example. This is for class A, which is 10.128.20.10/8. First of all, what we do is to find its default subnet mask. This is slash 8, meaning that the first 8 bits represent the network part. So its default subnet mask will be 255.0.0.0, meaning that from that point we'll be able to identify the network part and the host part. So therefore, after identifying the host part, we'll set the host bits to 0. So therefore, our network will be 10.0.0.0. Then we set the host bits to 1 to get the broadcast address. Therefore, broadcast address will be 10.255.255.255. Okay. Because this is slash 8, meaning that the number of 1 bit binary bits representing the network are 8. To get the number of binary bits representing the host, we subtract that 2 minus this 8, we get 24. So the total number of addresses will be 2 power 24, which give us that value. Then to get the total number of available address within this class A will be 2 power 24 minus 2 to give us the total number of available addresses that can be assigned to hosts. Then here we have got special IP addresses. So we say that some IP addresses in the IP address space have special meanings and functions. So first of all, we talk about limited broadcast. So which is given by 255.255.255. It is used as the destination broadcast address. Then next we have got, before we talk about any, IP address. Let's take a note here that it's the usage of the broadcast address is limited by a gateway. What does that mean? Means that when you send a broadcast packet, when it gets to a router, the router discards. The router cannot forward it beyond the layer 3. Okay, but for layer 2, the packet can be forwarded endlessly. The next is IP address, any IP address that is 0.0.0. So let's say during the startup, a machine should get an IP address from the DHCP server. But when it fails, it will send a DHCP request message with the destination set to limited broadcast. Then the source address will be set to any network, which is 0.0.0. Okay, so when the DHCP server receives the request, it will send a DHCP reply with the IP address set for the machine. Okay, then next is the loopback address, which is 127.0.0.0/8. This one is generally used for diagnostic. Lastly, we have got link local address, which is 169.254.0.0/24. So let's say the DHCP which is supposed to assign address to a machine is not available. The device will use this address temporarily for communication. Okay. Then lastly, we're going to talk about private IP addresses. So we have got public IP address and private IP address. So what's the difference? So for public IP address, we can use them through the internet, but for private, we can't use them through the internet. So to be able to use the private IP address over the internet, we must use what is called network address translation, which will translate the private address to public address. Then within the private addresses, we have for class A, we have a range, which is 10.0.0.0 to 10.255.255.255. Class B is 172.16.0.0 that one. Class C is 192.that1 that. So if an IP address falls within class A, but it is not within this range, we'll consider it as a public address. The same to class B. If the IP address is a class B, but does not fall within this range, it will be considered a public address. The same to class C here. If it's a class C but does not fall within this bracket, we'll consider it as a public address. So take note here, sometimes they like asking this question, which one is not a valid private address. So guys, thank you for watching the video. That's all I had for you today in the first module. So the first module, I say, we'll talk about IP address, which was to help you understand the IP address so that when we now talk about subnets, we now be able to understand what is happening. So thank you. Continue supporting the video. Just hit the like button and also subscribe. And again, share your comment in the comment section below so that I can know what you want me to upload for you, what you want me to talk about, to discuss, help you discuss. Okay? Thank you.